Hey, it's Dave. We're in the firework collectible area where they sell old packs of firecrackers and things from back in the day. This gentleman here, Bob, sells stuff. Look what he has here. Are these called penny packs?
They're called penny packs.
A penny.
A penny.
That's what they were probably back in the day, huh?
There's some in there worth $1,500.
Wow. These one penny, you know, would buy you that little pack of firecrackers back in the day.
If you were a kid and you went into a fireworks stand,
yeah,
and you got fireworks and you had 13 cents,
okay,
you could get two nickel packs.
Yeah.
Would the guy give you another pack for 3 cents? Hell no. No, you got to have a nickel.
Right.
But if you had the penny packs, you got three penny packs.
He got the pennies.
When you left, you spent all of your money and you were tickled to death because you came back with all fireworks. And the guy that sold them to you was tickled to death. He got all your money.
That's right.
Every damn penny.
No matter what denomination, the dime, a penny, a nickel.
He got everything.
Show us something really valuable. Why I got you.
Over here.
Huh?
Down this way.
Hey, let's follow you. Well, you got it right there, sir, huh? Let's see. Oh, yeah.
$3,000 a pack. Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Only five packs known.
Of this?
Of this.
Wow.
Particular. Mm-hmm. Each firecracker has a little gollywog on it. They call it a logo. And there's 20 in a package. There's only five of those packs known.
I don't even know what a gollywog is.
Gollywog is a black person.
Oh, okay, yeah.
We don't use that terminology in the United States, but in England they do.
Oh, I get it. Okay. Yeah. This is black memorabilia,
they
call it.
Yeah, black memorabilia.
Yeah.
That's why it's expensive.
I see. I'll be damned.
And there's only five of those.
Uh-huh.
And then here is a knockoff. Somebody trying to capitalize on a market, and they print a label, and they do that, and then they rewrap it, and they take it out to flea markets. Get $5 or $10 out of it. People think they're getting something.
Yeah,
it's a knockoff. It's a counterfeit.
You're not gonna believe it. There's people I'll see on the internet every once in a while, and they'll say, "Oh, look at these old firecrackers I found. Look how good a condition they're in. They're reproductions."
Not anymore.
And the mermaid. Somebody redid those.
Mermaids. I've got some reproduction mermaids.
Yeah. Now these this is the one I'm familiar with, Dixie Boy.
And these four here are all reproductions.
Are they repos?
You never seen reproductions small.
No.
You only see reproductions in standard type packs.
On little ones.
Yeah. This guy knows his stuff, and believe me, he knows exactly what he's got.
Here, this is. Oh, in other words, they're not going to repo that little one.
Yeah, they're not going to redo the little ones.
Yeah.
Here's how you can tell a repo.
Here, let's look.
Number one, they glue the label on all the way.
Yeah.
Now, the Chinese would stick their finger in a paste, hit the label, and stick the label on it. They're very fragile or frugal with their stuff.
Yeah.
That's number
dabbing.
One.
They called it dabbing.
All right.
Dabbing.
This is, the label's paste on 100%. They never did that.
That's right. I remember the labels were loose.
Here you got clear wrapping. You can see the little black guy in there.
Yeah.
Here they got red wrapping. You can't see it. The wrapping is different.
Yep.
This is different. And the final clue to it is, you see that says 20 on it?
Yeah.
That says 16 on it. That's how many firecrackers in here. You look at that little, it says 8016. That's a brick. They toppied a brick, reduced it to size, stuck it on there.
That's
I pick
right.
it up and I look at it and I say, that's a reproduction.
They got the outside label. And
yeah.
Shrunk it down.
Shrunk it down. That label, right there, just the label, it's like right here, that piece of paper.
Yeah. Boy, if you had a brick of those, you'd really be sitting on something, huh?
The label sold for $1,600. And all it is a piece of paper that big.
It's amazing.
And it brought $1,600.
You know, now with computers, you got to watch people reproduce it.
Yes.
If there's money in it, but they got to have a market for it.
Yeah.
They take them to the flea market.
People don't know.
They bring it out here, these guys are going to say no.
Yeah. Well, that's good. We got a little education there. Yeah, that's I know black memorabilia is collectible all over, and, and if they only made so many of those.
They probably made a million of them, but this is all that's left.
Yeah, burn them up. People burn them.
Burn them up. That's what they're for.
That's what it is, yep. Light them on fire. Now, you have a firecracker back there, I remember, with that lollipop string or whatever it's called. It's like a bigger firecracker. I remember buying those in Tijuana, Mexico when I was a kid.
Okay.
With my parents. It's back in that case. It's about this big with that pajama paper or whatever. It's got a little fuse like that, like a loop. Yeah, somebody said they call it a lollipop fuse.
Okay.
Yeah, but I saw you have them there. That's kind of. Do you have any packs like that with those? Like with the bigger ones?
Let's see. One right there.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There you go. How long have you been doing this, sir?
Since 2002.
2002?
Yeah.
You obtained quite a bit here.
What you see is about a tenth of my collection.
A tenth?
I have in my fireworks store, I got 11 display cases.
Yeah. Oh, you sell fireworks, didn't you?
I sell fireworks.
Yeah. What state you out of?
Missouri.
Oh, here it is. They used to throw these down and light them. Torpedoes. Oh, here you go.
Here's one of my display cases.
So if somebody comes to your store, they're going to get a treat looking at all this, huh?
Here's another display case.
Yeah. What's the name of your store, sir?
Bob's Fireworks.
Bob's?
Bob, right in the middle of the state of Missouri.
Bob's Fireworks, okay. I like it. Very nice.
The problem with that case, that's all it'll hold.
Or you'd put more in it, huh?
I could put more in it if I had a place. I don't have a place.
Well, your wife got some space, I bet, but she ain't giving it to you.
No more.
Now, these are the ones that you throw down. Yeah, these are all two, I believe.
50s, 60s.
Yeah, torpedoes. These were probably dangerous.
I would say so.
Do not sell to children.
They don't exist anymore.
Oh, look, lady fingers. Wow, I like it. I used to like lady fingers.
Now, so that you know, the lady fingers had 50 milligrams of powder.
That's what I keep thinking, yeah.
The new firecrackers that you buy today got 50 milligrams in them.
Yeah.
They passed the law on all the powder they can put in.
Yeah.
The new ones is what they used to put in the lady fingers.
Only it looks bigger. Yeah. Look, so that tells you what you're buying today.
Yeah, that's how much powder it's in.
You're buying lady fingers, they call them.
There used to be like 2 grains of powder in the firecrackers like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, there'd be 2 grains. Now it's 50 millimeters. It's 50. Millimeters.
Every once in a while,
milligrams.
Yeah.
Milligrams.
Every once in a while, they sneak some good ones in, you know. But most of them aren't worth much. The new ones, yeah.
The only thing I know about metric is a metric cookie. You know what a metric cookie is?
Cookie.
A graham cracker.
Graham. There you go. That's a good one. Yeah, let's scan up this way.
Tremendous amount of snow.
Oh, it's great. Yeah, it's great. Now, are these lady fingers too?
Yeah, those are what they call candy bars. Because you see how they're shaped?
Yeah.
There's like 350 of those little lady fingers in there.
Oh, man.
They might have sold for a quarter, 50 cents. Can you imagine making 350 firecrackers?
It's a low profit thing even today, I bet, you know? Yeah, look, I mean, it's a candy bar. I like it.
You refer to candy bars.
Yeah. Now, this one might have been out of, may have been out of Canada.
Could very well be.
These. Maybe not. I'm thinking of rocket ship or, no, this is something different. I got a couple at home, not many.
No, these are candy bars.
Yeah.
These were probably made for the children. Chinese market.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have anything in American on them.
Yeah.
They're made for the Chinese kids. Whatever. And then you get out here. These are penny packs.
Yeah.
Here's hex packs.
Oh, I don't even remember these.
I never saw any when I was a kid. Never.
No.
And then when I started collecting, there's a guy out in Illinois had a very extensive collection. Yeah. And I started looking for them.
What'd you call them again?
A hex packs. They're like hex
packs. Yeah. Are those like the, will they all go at once or?
No, you took them apart.
Oh, they're on rolls.
Yeah, they were just a way to package them.
Yeah.
It was faster than braiding them together.
Now here, this is what I'm telling you I remember right here.
Okay. Yeah, with the double fuse.
There was like five or six in a pack.
Yeah.
And man, were these things loud. You know, it was pretty up there, I remember that.
Most all that's got the powder dumped out, yeah. So I can display it.
Here's the Indian one.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah, that's from India. And I'm going to guess what, these are original M80s?
That's a silver tube salute,
yeah.
Or a bulldog. That's an M80, no powder in it. Silver tube salute.
Yeah.
Cherry bomb.
Yeah.
And there's the torpedoes that you threw on the ground.
Oh, I never saw a torpedo, to be
That's
honest.
That's what they are, right there.
It looks like a cherry bomb with no fuse.
No fuse, yeah.
Yeah.
And you just threw them down real hard.
Now, what's the silver salute I remember that was a little bigger than that?
Yeah, they were all that size.
Were they? See, I guess in your mind, they're always bigger than you think, you know?
I dumped the powder out of that one,
yeah.
And this one. There was 2 grams of powder in each one.
2 grams?
2 grams.
Okay.
They don't exist anymore. Somebody wrote, well, you don't find them in the store. And I said, the only place they exist is in your imagination.
Yeah.
They're not out there.
No.
Nobody's making them.
Ooh, where was this one at? I don't remember.
I have no idea.
I don't remember that. Is there a fuse on it?
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I never saw that one.
And then when we were a kid, they had
triangles.
Those are from Mexico.
Yeah.
When we were a kid, they had the car bombs.
Oh, this is the one when you went to start the car.
You went to start your car up. You put it. That's when the hoods would pop open.
Yeah, yeah.
You can't pop a hood.
Yeah.
They put one on a spark. One wire would go to spark plug. The other one would ground. You get in the car, turn the ignition on. You start whistling and smoking.
Yeah.
You think the goddamn car was on fire. And it's whistling. And after about a minute, it would blow up.
Moving around.
Scared the hell out of the guy that was in the car.
Yeah. Big joke, huh?
The big
joke. Yeah, look, auto alarm. Boy, some of these are old, man.
No one's in the back.
Cop caller.
That's nice.
Auto fooler.
Yep.
And when you come up to a place like this, you walk around, you bring your case, and you look to see if somebody's got something different.
Yeah.
Maybe for sale.
Yeah.
And then you buy it, you put it in here.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Yeah.
This is probably like a lot of hobbies. Once you start collecting, you don't know where to stop. You know what? There's a firecracker, I think this one guy I know has. Mailman used to carry it. The scared dogs and stuff. Yeah, I forget it had a name on it. Yeah.
There's some of the books, and you can buy the book here, is about Chinese firecrackers.
Yeah.
And there's a page in there where they show somebody building a house. They take firecrackers and they put them in a wall.
In case of a fire.
If you have a fire, the firecrackers are going off.
Yeah.
Here's your early smoke alarms.
That's right.
Or
I saw that, yeah.
It didn't cost you anything, a nickel.
Yeah, put them in the wall.
Put them in the wall.
House is on fire. No, it's the kids playing with fireworks, right?
for 50 cents, you could alarm your house.
Yeah.
Forever.
All right, Bob, you're looking good, buddy.
Thank you.
Thanks for showing up.
Hey, have fun. This is what it's all about. It's not